activity is a Frisbee activity, and we're gonna call this the hut takedown. And if you can look out here, we have our hula hut set up, and I do have a video on some of the other ones about how to set it up. So make sure you set up your hula huts. We have 5 set up because that's about as many hula hoops as we have to set up. We'd have more if we could. What we do is we have our students pair up because we have larger sizes. You can have them go on their own, but they'll need a Frisbee. And we tell them stand behind a black line, and they're going to throw it and try to knock down the hula hut. Okay? We have some on this side and some on the other side. So we got a lot of kids throwing it one time. So they're going to throw it and try to knock down the hut. Well, I missed. I simply run out and go get it and go back. When I come back, if I have a partner, I let my partner have a turn. If there's no partners, then I would just come back and throw it. Let's say I throw the Frisbee and I knock down the hula hut. I need to set the hula hut back up. So I come out, pause down. Oh, yay! All right, so I first set it back up so that way we still have a target to aim at. Making sure that the hula hoops are inside of the one on the bottom. Put my last one on top. Now I can get a beanbag for my points. We have beanbags on the sides. Here's my point for knocking down the hula hut. I get my Frisbee and I go back and I do it again. Or I hand it to my partner. Okay, and we're collecting beanbags. And at the end, when class is over, we'll ask the students like how many beanbags you have, or we might say, count all your purple beanbags or your orange beanbags, whatever we see that fits. So this was a lot of fun watching the students play, and I hope that your students will enjoy it as much as ours have. I'm Coach Pirillo reminding you to keep on moving.